So today I want to take a little bit of a step back and talk about the potential for equities to have a very low return environment for the next maybe 5 to 10 years, maybe closer to 10 years. And there are some very important reasons why that's, in our opinion, by our research, quite likely to happen. So I wanted to walk you through this a little bit because a lot of people have gotten very used to the S&P making them 10 to 15% a year. The long-term 90-year average is indeed about 10% per year for the S&P, but that's an average number. For the past decade, the S&P has returned about 14.9%, or I think 13.9%, excuse me, that's like 40% more. So I think when you have a decade like that, you're coming into a new decade like the one we've just entered, and you're going to have much, much lower returns. And the reason I want to kind of bring this out there, because I think for a lot of people it's going to be a problem because they're banking on their retirement account or just on their investment strategy to give them a higher return. But we have very, very low interest rates, and that's the key here to understand. So what we're going to do is look at this chart here, and I'm prepared a couple of words on a document here I'll show you. But this is the trajectory of the bond yields looking at the 10-year U.S. Treasury note. You can see at some point in the mid-80s we had 10-year yields well into the mid to low teens, so like 13, 14, 15. And now you're looking at, you know, somewhere around 50 to 70 basis points depending on when you look. Now, the long-term trajectory does remain lower, but it is quite likely that at some point that will return to the upside, particularly with the Fed's new sort of adapted policy rate, where they're basically saying they're not going to raise rates for a couple of years at least, and basically let inflation go higher, or give inflation more of a chance to go higher, and that in turn should at some point lead to bond yields going higher. And the reason why this is important for equities is because of the following. If you have a low return environment with rates near zero, equities, albeit competitive, are also going to relatively have lower returns. So let me walk you through a couple of the bullet points here. So as I said before, our base case is that we are going to see equities return have lower returns for like the next 10 years or so. And if you look at what equities have done for the past 10 years, again, very sharp rise. So a lot of these returns, the 14% average over the past 10 years in the S&P, it's brought forward returns, right, for like the next 10 years. Again, the long-term average is like 10%. Again, close interest rates close to zero. It's a really, really important point. I know for some people that might be a bit dry, but it's the major driver for most things. So if you believe at some point we will see higher inflation, or at least some inflation, and that in turn is going to lead to higher rates, at some point interest rates, bonds, become more competitive again to equities, in which case I think we could easily see a big shift over into equities. Again, we're not saying this is going to happen today or tomorrow. This is really a longer-term picture outlook, and this is really ultimately where most of the money is being made by having these asset allocation shifts that are paramount of importance to your longer-term financial well-being. So that's one important point. Now, we look at corporations. Corporations are most likely, at least that's what currently the consensus is in a lot of different places, we're going to face higher taxes. We have to somehow pay for an aging population, for deficits. So this is not really a political thing, but it's quite likely that taxes, at least in some shape or form, are going to go up, which is also why for in the U.S. a Roth IRA makes sense, where you pay taxes now and not later, as opposed to the other way around, because if you pay taxes now, you presumably pay lower taxes now than later. But that's a bit of a side topic. We can always talk about that more. If you guys want to hear more about that kind of stuff, leave a comment down below. So that's one thing where we think companies are going to have higher operating costs going forward, in part because of some deglobalization trends that we think we may have just kicked off due to the COVID crisis, among other things. So again, low interest rates threatening to at some point go higher with inflation going higher. That's one point that would have equities have a lower return. And then the actual equities themselves, corporations having higher costs, basically, whether that's taxes or input costs due to globalization and those kinds of things. So this is important because for a lot of people, again, they've basically been banking on a 10% return, 15% return in the S&P 500, which most people's strategies are very closely related or tagged, particularly US and North America in general, to the broader equity indices, a little bit less so in Europe. Nevertheless, what does it mean for you? It means for you that I think a somewhat more proactive approach is probably warranted. I think piling into just a bunch of trend following systems and piling into your favorite mega cap stocks is probably not going to lead to great performance, may not lead to horrible performance, but not to probably not to good enough performance over time for the for the foreseeable future. And you'll probably see a return to a more active investing, nothing hectic, but we've seen we are currently in a massive passive investing bubble because the indices have massively outperformed most any strategies. Of course, that's not hard to believe. If the S&P goes up 15% every year on average for a decade, you can hardly keep track of that with any strategy. So those are some of the dynamics. If you enjoyed this, if you have questions or comments, leave them down below.